Namaste, welcome to Bhavna's kitchen. Today I'm making Masoor Dal fry. So yummy, tempting and healthy as well. So let's look at the ingredients first. 1 cup of Masoor Dal. Here is how it looks like. Ginger, garlic and green chili paste as per your taste. Adrak, lahsun, hari mirch. Mix of oil and ghee. You can take only oil or only ghee. It's really up to you. Here I have different spices and ingredients. Whole dry red chilies. Garam masala to taste. Salt to taste. Pinch of turmeric powder, haldi. Pinch of asafoetida, hing, optional. Mustard seeds, rye. Cumin seeds, jeera. Vegetables and herbs, I'm going to use onion, tomato, carrot is optional, coriander leaves, curry leaves if you have available. Here I have masoor dal. You can see the orange color, that's the masoor dal, and the yellow color is moong dal. Well, I'm not going to use moong dal, but I just wanted to decorate this cup and I want to show you how wonderful these dals look, and when you cook they are so yummy. Now this is the split skinless masoor dal. When it's whole, it looks like brown color. This is how whole masoor looks like. The skin is kind of a brown color. You can see that some of the dal in here.
And it is known as brown lentil. Now, it doesn't retain its orange color when you cook. It turns into yellow color again when you cook. But I simply love the color of this dal. And to retain a little bit of color of this curry, I add carrot. Not just to retain the color, but it's another way to make your kids eat some vegetables in the curry. My kids love any kinds of dals, so I just keep blending some vegetables that they won't even notice. So let's get started.
Rinse this dal and rinse several times, changing water till it runs the clear water. Alright, so I'm done rinsing dal. Peel and wash carrot and shred.
Now carrot is totally optional, and if desired you can even chop carrot very fine, but I have kind of picky kids, so I always prefer to shred and add in this recipe.
Carrot is ready.
Alright, so I'm going to put this on the side and I'm going to chop tomatoes now, and I'm going to chop tomato roughly. You don't have to chop fine.
So I'm going to cut in a big chunk. Alright.
All the preparation are done and it's time to cook now. Here I have this pressure cooker and I'm going to boil dal first. If you don't have pressure cooker, don't worry, you can boil dal in open pot as well. And then later I'm going to pour tadka seasoning on the top.
Alright, so turn on the stove on a medium to high heat. Add dal into the pressure cooker. No need to add oil or ghee when you boil the dal, but if desired you can add a little bit of oil. Dump this tomato in as well, carrot as well, ginger, garlic and green chili paste. You can even chop ginger, garlic and green chili and add into this recipe. Salt to taste, turmeric powder. Add water. For 1 cup of dal you will need about 2 cups of water. Look at this, how nice it looks already. Alright, so this pot is ready and ready to cover. Pressure cooker. Put the whistle on. And I'm going to hear about 3 whistles. 3 or 4 whistles is enough. It's dal, so it doesn't take too long to cook. While dal is cooking, I'm going to do a few preparation for tadka.
Chop onion very fine.
Alright, so onion is ready. Take the onion. Fresh dhania to garnish on top, coriander leaves and chop very fine. Alright,
so I already heard 4 whistles. Dal is ready. I'm going to put this on the side and now prepare tadka seasoning to garnish on top of the dal.
Alright, so turn on the stove on a medium heat and heat up mix of oil and ghee. You can use butter. Add dry whole red chilies, lal mirch. Here I have fresh curry leaves. Just get all the leaves.
Now add mustard seeds, rice, and let it pop. Cumin seeds, jeera, asafoetida, pink, optional. Now again, I'm going to add a pinch of a turmeric powder here in my tadka as well. All right, so this is looking perfect. Bring down the temperature on a low now. And I'm going to add this curry leaves. Be very careful when you add curry leaves. Add onion. Give it a quick stir. And cook this onion till edges are little golden brown color. And have a fresh lime or lemon. Give a nice twist to dal. So I'm going to cut half of lemon into slices and half of it I'm going to squeeze in my dal. Slices are just to decorate my plate, so it's really up to you. Cut from the middle, get this, and nice slices, perfect. Let's check onion. This is how I cook onion, and it's ready. Turn off the stove. You see here, slightly brown color. All right, so the dal is ready. Tadka is ready and ready to prepare the plate. Move this now, onion, and bring back this pressure cooker, and I'm going to open it and I'm going to show you how it looks like, and I'm going to add few more ingredients. Release pressure all the way and open it. You see, I told you that the orange color of lentil turns into yellow when you cook. Now into this dal, I'm going to squeeze this fresh lemon, and here I have this garam masala. Now once dal is cooked, and if you think that you need to add more water, you can always add water any point of time, but this looks perfect. The garam masala, when you add garam masala, it brings a nice aroma. All right, so I'm going to take out dal into this bowl, pour this tadka on top. You can also again smear some melted ghee on top or butter. Finely chopped dhania, coriander leaves, and take a look at this bowl. And to go with this masoor dal fry, I prepared kulchas, lemon slice, perfect. Take a look at this combination, masoor dal fry with paneer kulcha, looking awesome. The best combination ever, and I'm ready to give it a bite. Dip into the masoor dal fry. So this was about preparing masoor dal fry. Thank you for watching, and I will see you soon with another great recipe.